58. Genocides happen in every corner of the world, to every type of people. The numbers in the past 100 years are staggering. The Turks slaughtered more than 1 million Armenians during World War I. In the 1930s and 40s, the Japanese killed millions across Asia. In the Soviet Union, the estimated number of deaths in the Gulag camps and beyond is more than 8 million. The Germans slaughtered 6 million Jews and millions more during World War II. In the 1950s and 60s, the Communist Chinese killed an estimated 30 million. And during the 1970s, the Khmer Rouge killed 1.7 million Cambodians, fully 20% of that country's population. Bosnia, Rwanda, Congo, Darfur. All told, in our time, there have been more than 100 million innocent victims of genocide, more than all the combat deaths in all the wars fought during that time everywhere in the world. Based on the human toll alone, genocide and mass slaughter are worse problems plaguing humanity than war. We need to understand why. Genocide is always the decision of one leader or a small group of leaders. These individuals make a choice to initiate the killing, which in every case means they could have also chosen not to. The leader's goals vary depending on time, place, and circumstance. Pol Pot wanted to radically transform Cambodian society. Turkish leader Mehmet Halat wanted to restore Turkey's decaying empire. Adolf Hitler wanted to create a vast political empire ruled by the German master race. Colonel Teonist Bakasora and his fellow Hutu leaders wanted to secure political power in Rwanda for the Hutu. And in the Balkans, Slobodan Milosevic wanted to permanently redraw the political map of the region.
Erkennt man einen Juden?
Wie erkennt man einen Juden?
Setzen. Das ist ganz einfach. Das jüdische Blut hat eine völlig andere Zusammensetzung als das unsere. Der Jude hat eine hohe Stirn, eine Hakennase. Hinterschädel, abstehende Ohren und einen watschelnden Gang. Sein Blick ist listig und hinterhältig. Er schaut einem niemals gerade in die Augen. Er fuchtelt mit den Händen, gestikuliert, übertrieben. Er kriecht vor euch, aber lässt eure Aufmerksamkeit nach, spricht euch an die Kehle. Der nordische Mensch ist das Prachtstück dieser Erde. Er ist das strahlendste Beispiel für die Schöpfungsfreude. Er ist nicht nur am begabtesten, sondern auch am schönsten. Sein Haar ist hell wie das reife Korn. Seine Augen sind so blau wie ein Sommerhimmel. Seine Bewegungen sind voller Harmonie. Sein Körper ist vollkommen.
It's striking that it is a former SS man, invoking Anne Frank, who makes this point. It is an important one. It is that failure to see the humanity in others which makes it possible for the killers to commit their crimes. I would add that it's the belief that those others are dangerous enemies which inspires the perpetrators to kill with such zeal. Years ago, I encountered an episode of the Holocaust which spoke volumes about the willfulness and dedication of the killers. and I got to know one of the survivors, Lily Silbiger.
I have a map here with me which actually outlines the route from Helmbrecht to Volari. Here is Helmbrecht.
In the last months of World War II, as the Allied forces neared the concentration camps housing Jews and others, Germans emptied their camps and drove their prisoners on forced marches through the nearby towns and countryside. The death marches left a trail of corpses in their wake, and the marching prisoners were described by more than one witness as the walking dead. These are actual photos of the young women who were with Lily on the march.
To video and DVD. She grew up.
Miss Anne Frank was radiant at the Prince's Ball last night. Quite a glamour girl, wouldn't you say?
In a world that was changing.
My sister begs me to send the children to London to live with her.
And will you?
Well, it's better if we stay together. Hope for the best.
Her life.
We're not going to wait for the Nazis to drag us away. We'll simply disappear.
Would never be the same.
How long will we be in hiding?
Perhaps a month or two. Until the war's over.
But her spirit refused to die.
After the war, I'm going to live.
Critics have hailed Anne Frank as remarkable, undeniably powerful, a stunning tribute.
I know where they're hiding.
Academy Award winner Ben Kingsley, Brenda Blethyn, Lily Taylor, and introducing Hannah Taylor Gordon as Anne.
You've suffered before and it's only made us stronger.
The story that goes beyond anything you've ever heard.
Wie man der Gießer